Honorable members, Sri Vaiko ji will speak its maiden speech. So let us.
Thank you very much, Mr. Deputy Chairman Sir. This day is a memorable day of my 55 years of public life, as it happens to be the maiden speech in this August House after 23 years. Opportunity is the blessed gift in a man's life. That is why Thomas Gray, in his poetry, Elegy Written in a Country Churchyard, said, "Full many a gem of purest rays rain the dark unfathomed caves of ocean, where full many a flower is born to bless unseen and waste its sweetness on the desert air." Sir, ability is of little account without opportunity, says Jefferson, the founding father of the Constitution of the United States of America. Sir, 41 years ago, in 1978, the opportunity to enter this house was bestowed upon me by the dedicated disciple of Tandai Periyar and Arinyar Anna, the president of DMK, Dr. Kalanjar Karunanidhi, in 1978, again in 1984, again in 1993 times. I was molded by Mr. Murasali Maran, the president of the DMK parliamentary party, and the first speech when I made maiden speech, Bhuvesh Gupta and N.G. Ranga applauded this young small man. Sir, today this time, the president of the DMK, the leader of the opposition of the Tamil Nadu Assembly, my beloved brother, Thalapathi M.K. Stalin, has given this opportunity to enter this house. So I owe my gratitude to Dr. Kalanjar, to Murasali Maran, and Mr. Thalapathi Stalin. Sir, the time at my disposal is very short, but I have to recall the words of Arinyar Anna when he entered this August house in April 1962, in his maiden speech, Arinyar Anna stated, "I belong to the Dravidian stock. I am proud to call myself a Dravidian. That doesn't mean I am against a Bihari or a Maharashtrian or a Bengali or a Keralite. Why I say I belong to the Dravidian stock? The Dravidians have got a distinct, different, concrete things to deliver to the subcontinent. Sir, this bill, which I oppose vehemently, is to strangulate the voice of the minorities, the voice of the freedom-loving people. This bill, sir, whoever comes to power, when they are in opposition, they oppose the draconian provisions. The great Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru opposed Preventive Detention Act of the British Raj. But when they came to power, they used the same Preventive Detention Act. Madam Indira Gandhi, when he won the battle in Bangladesh, when she entered the house, the great lamented Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji welcomed her as the Durga of India. But what happened? Who abolished the privy purses? Who nationalized the banks? When she was defeated in the court, in the Allahabad High Court, when she was disqualified, what happened? Total revolution call was given by the Lok Nayak J. Prakash Narayan and all the leaders joined. But on the dead night of 25th June, when the Ram Lila meeting was going on, democracy was murdered in this country. And what happened? The same morning, all the leaders, including J. Prakash Narayan, Morarji Desai, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, L.K. Advani, all were arrested, detained behind the bars. And my leader at that time, the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, he declared a resolution against the emergency, which was declared as the Magna Carta by EMS Nambudiri comrade, EMS Nambudiri Paul. The government of DMK was dismissed for this whole reason on 30th January 1976, on the very same night, I myself, along with 500 cadres, were detained under MISA. I spent two jail terms in Palayangottai and Salem. Sir, what happened? The result, the people did throw away the government. When they came back, Madam Indira Gandhiji came back as the Prime Minister of India, they did not learn the lesson which they got previously. They brought the Tada Act. My own brother, blood brother Ravi Chandran, who gave shelter to the wounded who have lost their limbs of the LTTE, he was arrested under Tada. He was put in the prison. Whenever he was taken to the court at the hospital, his hands were chained, he was handcuffed. Then what happened? Again, this government, Atal Bihari Vajpayee treated me like his son. He stated in a meeting in Bihar, Vaiko is like my son. But what happened? When they wanted to bring Putta, myself and Murasali Maharan opposed the NDA meeting. Only one thing I could achieve, that the move to put the press one and journalists behind the bars was deleted. But what has happened? I was the first victim of this country. I was the only member of parliament who was put behind the bars under Putta for 19 months. Mr. Ajit Patel Bihar, by the Jayalalitha government, used that Putta. Jayalalitha was the chief minister. Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, I was told by his adopted daughter, wanted to meet, see me, interview me in the jail, but the protocol stopped him. Therefore, he requested His Excellency, the Vice President of India, the present chairman, Mr. Venkaiah Naidu, to go and meet me in the Vellur prison. My beloved brother, the great revolutionary, George Fernandez, came thrice to see me in the jail. Sir, I filed a writ petition from the jail to the Supreme Court, giving support to the cause of a banned organization, LTTE. Is it a crime? Will it come under the purview of the Putta Act? The great lawyer, Fali Nariman, appeared for me. The judges gave the verdict, give mere speech supporting a banned organization like LTTE will not come under the purview of the 21 Putta Act. After 19 months, I had to come to face the elections. I didn't contest. Had I contested, that would have been different. But sir, today I want to tell you, here the great Sukundra Sekhar Rao was quoting about the sedition law. Under sedition, great Bal Gangadhar Tilak was sentenced for 6 years imprisonment. Today is the death anniversary of the great leader Tilak. Mahatma Gandhi was sentenced under 124A Sedition Act. And when Arvind Ghosh was convicted, Desabandhu Chittaranjan Das, what is stated here, my friend, he is standing before the bar of the High Court of History, long after this controversy is hushed in silence, long after this turmoil, long after he is dead and gone, he will be looked upon as the poet of patriotism, as the prophet of nationalism and the lover of humanity. Sir, you know, all my brothers, you will be shocked to know, I have been convicted under 124A since independence. I am the only person I have been convicted under 134A sedition charge last month. Now today I am on bail. My case is coming in another 2 weeks in the High Court of Madras. If the sentence is enhanced to 2 years, I will lose the membership the moment I will be disqualified. I do not care. I do not care about anything in my life. I live for principles. But the only person who has been convicted under sedition law after independence, this is the simple fellow. I am not Tilak. You are a mountain. I am a molehill. I am a drop. I am a humble man. But I have, for what reason? my support to the cause of the LTTE and Elam. I have been branded as a traitor of this country for my support. I come from a Congress family. As a student, I joined the DMK movement. Totally, I have spent 5 years in jail. The best place for a politician to learn and write is prison. This is my experience. Sir, now today, this bill, because I have to look at the
you clock. Speak.
8 o'clock, you have already given the dead. Sir, the bill unlawful activities prevention bill. This is the original act I am having. One minute. This bill has been passed in the Lok Sabha with the intention as stated to align the law with the international obligations as mandated in several conventions and Security Council resolutions on this issue. This bill would empower the government to designate individuals as terrorists, among other changes. Honorable Home Minister, Mr. Amit Shah Ji, had said in the Lok Sabha during the discussions of the bill that when you have fear in your mind, then what can I do? I have got all respect for my Home Minister. But who is fear? What reason, for what reason Kalburgi was killed? Narendra Volkar was killed. Govind Bansare was killed. Gauri Rankesh was killed. Sir, fear. The great poet Rabindranath Tagore, the Nobel laureate, in Gitanjali says, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, in so that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Sir, but such anti-terror legislation should not be misused to target human rights defenders, religious minorities, who already having been facing discrimination and reprisals. Albert Schweitzer, the Nobel laureate for his medical service to lepers in the dark areas of African continent, has written a book, Philosophy of the East. He says, Thirukkural, moral scriptures of great poet Thiruvalluvar, has no equal in literature around the world. Thiruvalluvar says in his couplet under the caption of the chapter, Tyranny, I quote, first I say in Tamil, Allalpattu aarchaadu aluda kannir andre selvathai theikkum padai, meaning unconsolable tears due to torture are the weapons which will destroy any establishment. The bill should be seen in conjunction with the recently passed National Investigation Agency Amendment Bill 2019, when NIA acts bias in cases where the perpetrators are from a majority community. How is it possible for the minority community to live without the fear of this law being misused against them? When such selective approach is being followed, NIA, why give more power to it? I was booked in two cases under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. One case was for delivering a speech in a hall meeting in Chennai. I was acquitted after the full trial. The other case was for undertaking a procession condemning the killing of Subhadra Premadselvan, LTTE leader, by the Sri Lankan military bombardment. When I challenged the invoking of UAPA before the Madras High Court, the entire charge sheet was quashed. Thus, I am standing example of misuse of MISA, TADA, POTA and UAPA. Coming to the Unlawful Activities Amendment Act 2019, I oppose the said amendment for reasons. One, it targeting the individuals, calling him a terrorist by the unilateral act of including his name in the fourth schedule, no opportunity is contemplated to hear the view of the individual before his or her name is included in the fourth schedule. The central government by this act is empowering themselves by issuance of a notification to include the name of any individual in the fourth schedule and declare him as a terrorist. It is highly undemocratic and unconstitutional in that the freedom of a human being is curtailed. Secondly, this amendment act empowers only the police officer not below the rank of deputy superintendent of police. Thirdly, this amending act bringing a fear on the minds of nation The nation is remaining under constant threat from inside and outside of the nation. The present central government is usurping the powers of the state governments by taking the right of the investigation by themselves. The basic structure of our nation, that is India, is Council of States. Hence, this country, my view, should be called as United States of India. This country should be called United States of India. The policy of one nation now being adopted by this government, I apprehend that the unity of India became endangered. The proposed amendment is totally unwarranted, as there are sufficient laws in force in Indian citizens or peace-loving people, always expressing their view through ballot and never resorted to any violence. I request the House to reject the bill, if not refer to the Select Committee for a detailed study. I would like to state Mr. Martin Sennenin, the former United Nations Special Rapporteur on the Promotion and Protection of Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms while Countering Terrorism, who wrote in an article that, for a while, the global consensus about the imperative of combating terrorism was so compelling that authoritarian governments could get away with their repressive practices simply by renaming political opponents as terrorists. This draconian, abominable, atrocious bill, unlawful activities preventive bill, should be rejected lock, stock and barrel. Otherwise, this bill will be thrown into the dustbin by the people in the future history of India. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Vaiko. This was your maiden speech.